More Tech Sir here, and are you sick of getting background noise in all your videos, or even when you're streaming you've got that humming noise from the PC or even from the fridge? Well, in today's video hopefully I've got a cure for you. Yes, that's right, we're going to be checking out OBS's new noise suppression. Now it is called RNNoise, hopefully I pronounced it right, and I've tested this just quickly and I've got to say it's going to be a game changer. So we're going to put it through its paces today, see what it's like, and then you can make the decision for yourself. So just to let you know my setup, I'm using a Technica 2020 mic. Yeah, it's quite old, but it does the job for me, and that's running through a USB mixer, which is the Alice, hopefully I pronounced that right, Multimix 4. So that's my equipment. So test wise, we're going to be doing the keyboard test, which everybody absolutely loves. Then we're going to be doing my cat's fountain. Now this is a water fountain and this makes hella noise when it needs refilling. Don't worry, the cat's got enough water because I filled other bowl up, so that's fine, but we're just doing it for the purpose of the test. And then after that we're going to be doing the Hoover. Yes, that's right, one of the most noisiest things you can ever get in the background. And if you haven't got a separate space and someone's hoovering in the background, this can be a really annoying thing. So we're going to check it out, and then finally we're going to be doing the music test. So I'm going to play some music in the background on my phone, and then we're going to be chatting, and we're going to be doing 15 second intervals on this. So we're going to test it with and without, and then we're going to compare the difference. So what I'm going to do first, guys, I'm going to show you actually where you can find this. So we're on OBS, as you can see we've got the Inception look going on. So all you have to do is go down to the mic, we go on to filters, and this is where we find it. So currently I've got it on at the moment, and this is the lower version, the previous version, which no one really went near because it was atrocious, let's be honest. But currently we've got it on at the minute, so we'll turn it off. So that's it off, and this is it back on. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go into full screen, and now we're going to do the test. So we're all good to go. Now we're going to do this first test. This is going to be the keyboard test, and we're going to do it for 15 seconds without the noise suppression. We're going to be talking throughout, and then you can make your mind up. Then we're actually going to put it on, and then you'll be able to see the actual difference. So here you go, I've got the stopwatch, if you can't actually see that. We're going to click it on down here, and then we're going to be good to go. So here we go in 3, 2, 1. There we go. So we're going to start typing, and we're just going to talk about anything really. What I will be doing, I will be doing a lot more videos like this as well, guys. I want to expand the channel out, not to just doing retro reviews, but doing more things like this, because it is a tech channel. So I'm going to be expanding that. So this is going to be one of the first videos that we've done with that, and hopefully we'll be doing many more on OBS as well, just so you can learn and understand how to use it, because it is a bit difficult if you never used it before. So we went over a bit, but that was 30 seconds, so we may have to do it a tiny bit longer than 15 seconds, because I think 15 seconds is a bit too short, so we may do 30 seconds per video. So we've got it turned on now, guys. So what we're going to do is we're going to capture this, and then we are going to see what kind of results we have got from this. So it's on. So here we go in 3, 2, 1. So this is me typing with a keyboard. Still going strong. And that's the test for that. So that's the test for the keyboard. And now what we're going to do is move on to the water fountain. So here we go in 3, 2, 1. Now we're just going to be talking throughout this and see if you can hear it. We're going to stop for a second. So hopefully you can pick that up in the background. It's a little trickle, not much, but it is quite loud and annoying when it is getting captured on the actual microphone. So as always, we're going to jump straight into it, and we're going to actually put this on now. You will see the actual difference in noise. We're going to carry on talking because I want to show you what it sounds like. So This is with it on now, so you can't really hear anything. I can't because I haven't got the headphones on, but hopefully you cannot hear the trickle in the background. As I say, this is with it on, and you can't hear anything at all, as far as I can tell from my decibel readings. We're getting no readings at all. So hopefully, even when I'm talking, hopefully it's not picking it up. So we'll have to see on that front. So now what we're going to do now is the music test. Just going to grab my phone, play some music in the background on the table behind me, and then we're going to see how it works out. We're going to play something a bit heavy and hard as well, because I don't want anything sort of, we need to put this to the test. So we're going to ramp it up. Let's go on my Spotify. Let's pick a bit of hard style. I'm really into that, you know. So, as you can see, we are actually playing this now. Oh, shit. And that's with the noise suppression on. That is crazy. Anyway, we're going to move into the background. So guys, this is with the noise suppression on. I'm not sure if it's feeding through when we are speaking, but when we don't speak, you can't hear it at all. So we're just going to go quiet for a second. So that was it without the noise suppression. Now we're probably going to get a Spotify advert in a second. No, actually not. That's cool. Right, what we're going to do now is we're going to turn it off. So here we go. We're turning it off in 3, 2, 1. So hopefully you can hear the music in the background now. I can already see it on the levels that it is picking it up. Anyway, enough of that. So we're going to switch it back on for a second. And I'm actually going to bring the phone over when I do it to show you that we're still playing live music. So as you can see there, guys, we're still playing live music. So that was the music test. Now it looked like it did work quite well, but as I say, I've not listened to this. So I once have listened back and reviewed it all, then I can put my findings together. Now we are going to do one of my favorite tests, the Hoover test. We're going to bring it in. We're just going to turn it on and then we're going to see how this reacts. So bear with me for 1 second, guys. I'm going to go and get the Hoover and then I'll be right back. So guys, if you didn't believe me, this is my shark hoover, and this is one animal when you turn it on. It's loud as hell. So we're going to put this to the test. We're going to put it behind us, and then we're going to see if the noise suppression can actually live up to its name. So guys, this is with the noise suppression on. We've got the Hoover in the background. Can't hear anything at all. Now we're going to turn it off and I'm going to show you what it sounds like. So here we go in 3, 2, 1. And oh my God, this is going to probably sound really hard to hear. It sounds like we have got a jet turbo engine in the kitchen. That's sticking at a good 35 decibels. So we're going to turn it off again, just so I'll show you the difference. Here we go. We're going to carry on talking. Now that's it switched off. And you pretty much, hopefully, can't hear anything at all. So guys, that was the Hoover test. So that was the final test chosen to use. Varies in decibels. As I say, we tried to pick as many different ones as possible to get different sounds and noises to truly test this out. Now, what I'm going to do now really quickly, I'm going to review all the footage, get it all packed together for you, and then I'll tell you all my findings and what my final thoughts are actually on this. So what are my results and finding? Now, when I listened back to the actual keyboard, the keyboard did really well. What I found across all the tests though, is that actually when you do speak, it does pick some background noise up. Very limited, very little, some worse than others. The Hoover, that was crazy, but it does pick some background noise up. So I guess the further away the actual device is or what you're using, then that's how much decibels it's gonna pick up. Now if you've got something like the fan or air conditioning in the actual room, then I'd highly recommend using this. This is gonna be great just to filter them annoying background noises out that you just can't turn off or you just have to deal with in life. But moving on to the actual test, so the keyboard for me, it did work really well. You couldn't really hear much when we were typing. Moving on to the fountain again, you couldn't really hear much because it's over in that corner of the kitchen. So and it was a little trickle, but it is quite loud in the actual room. And I've got no soundproofing in this room at all, so it does pick it up quite loud when you do turn it on. So that worked really well when we actually used this filter to suppress the noise. Now the phone music, I'd say yeah, it was okay, nothing special, nothing amazing. And then the Hoover, well, if someone's hoovering in the background, I probably just recommend not to stream or play any games. For free software, it's a massive step up for OBS in general and for noise suppression. Free, you don't have to buy an RTX and video card to utilize this software anymore. It's open source as well, which is really good, so it's free. And they're always working on it to improve it as well. So if you haven't got OBS, I'd highly recommend getting it just so you can test it out. But guys, as always, thank you so much for all the support. Don't forget to please like, rate and subscribe and hit that bell notification for all the latest and up-to-date videos straight to you. And as always guys, hopefully you've really enjoyed this video. We are going to be branching out into more videos like this as I explained earlier in the video. So this was just a first look on the noise suppression on OBS, on RNNoise. I think that's how you pronounce it. I always get it wrong, but anyway, yeah, hopefully you've enjoyed this and then you can make your judgment call on this by looking at this. Actually, as I say, I've done real life tests, none of this little fancy, put a little fan on in the background and if it doesn't work, it doesn't work. So make your own judgment call. As I say, guys, thank you so much for all the support and as always, I will see you soon.